So, I thought maybe I'll give a go on Goliath with the Tesla and the Forza Horizon 3. So yeah, sorry about the start. I just wanted to... I don't know why I did that really. I apologize. Nat! But yeah, I was hoping to get around this Goliath thing much quicker. But this car tops out 160, kind of my bad really. So, looks like you've got me for the next 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, we've got about, I'd say about 12 and a half minutes of driving in Forza Horizon 3 with the Tesla, trying it out. Throughout this video it goes from day to night, always night to day, my bad, was brilliant sunrise, and then that's the end of it. But yeah, it's kind of Black Panther RCF pearlescent colour on the Tesla, and the colour on the Tesla's to match the wheels I chose, which are the Turbine 52. I think that's what they're called, but I thought aerodynamics and that them wheels would be better. You probably saw them at the start. Didn't want to do more videos, but I don't know, Chrome sometimes, that's what I say. Yeah, tomorrow I'm hopefully gonna get some blood test stuff done, because I ain't feel too good at the moment. I'm supposed to be doing, like, it's kind of complicated with the situation. Like, I want to work, but I can't work. And then being kind of anemic, and like, I don't know what's happened the last couple of days, but I've got these parts on my skin where it's like swollen and red, and it hurts, but it's weird. Yeah. And my mouth's pretty messed up as well. Awesome, so positive, best stuff to talk about. But yeah, because I've kind of realised now that there's no chance of YouTube ever taking off for me. So, I kind of want to do something in my lifetime. I don't know whether I'll achieve much, or I just be ill all the time. Like, for example, I got my SIA badge through a scheme, so it was basically free to do the course, and I went for like two or three interviews, but basically called a crackhead and do I take drugs, and then I was ill for ages. And then like the last 2 years I think I've been quite a bit better since I got my ileostomy thing. But yeah, I don't know, sometimes life's crazy. And then Crohn's just makes it crazy. Don't know why I'm talking about my life. You came here for Teslas and Forzas. You didn't come to hear my life story. But then again, you might have done, because you enjoy my voice. Who knows what you enjoy? I don't know. I must admit, this game looks much better. And it's so weird, like some games, like recently I've noticed more detail in Ride 2, like a lot of the bikes, certain vanilles, or certain designs should I say, like certain colours, it's like the bike they scanned for the game was mad mashup, like the guy never polished it in his life, and you could see all the cuts in the paint. And then even one of the bikes had the number plate thing, the number plate holder with the brand bike on it had like mad markings and sort of like wear and tear on it. So kind of peculiar how they got that on the bikes, when some bikes just look brand new, like they've scanned a bike in a bike shop that's never been ridden. And then like for think it's the CB900. But yeah, that bike in Ride 2 looks mad, like it's gone through some type of emotional courier lifestyle. And you can see where the tires, like where dirt's stuck to the exhaust and rubber and whatever else, and it's all ingrained into the exhaust, and when they've scanned it, it's just on the exhaust permanently. And I noticed even when you change the pipes on that bike, it actually looks like the pipes on it standard, like from the intake all the way down to the end can, like this aftermarket purple type pipes. Because I don't know if, what is it they usually use? Because on mine is that black sort of nasty stuff that changes colour. But usually on motorbikes, I think they use stainless steel and like titanium, aluminium. I don't really know much about exhaust. But yeah, just thought I'd talk about that randomly, because this is Ride we're playing. Psych, it's got cars. Kind of disappointed recently because people are reckoning now Forza Horizon 4 is going to be in Japan. I'm not too sure. It would have been cool if it was in England, because like obviously Australia, that's where all the English sent prisoners back in the days, so it would be only righteous to go back to England. Yeah, excellent driving skills, pro driver. I don't even know how I did this so badly. It's not like the car's super speed, because there's an upgrade for this, and I think that's what gives it the ludicrous mode. But also, it's like when you look at the Tesla in the car shop bit, it literally says P90. I think it's P90 with ludicrous mode. It's like, yeah, this isn't just a normal Tesla, it's got ludicrous mode. But I actually thought most of the new P90s came with that. So it's like extra saying that, but like I don't know anything about anything, so I don't know. I'm not like a Tesla expert, I've never driven one, but from what I've heard, I always thought the sort of streetcar P90, the more recent version, like the one that was on Top Gear, had that ludicrous mode from then. So anything. But then again, like I said, I don't even know what I'm doing, man. I wasn't even gonna upload this, but like, the way I've been feeling recently, I just haven't done a video. And I feel like the way this YouTube thing goes with the algorithms and algorithms, it's just like, I've gotta put stuff out kind of regular, more often than every 3 days, I suppose. But I haven't been. But I suppose I'm gonna go now. It's up to you if you wanna watch the rest of the video of my poor driving skills. Up to you. But that's it from me. Take care and goodbye.